Good morning and welcome to St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church here in Columbia, Tennessee. And we're grateful to have another opportunity to praise God from whom all blessings flow. Yeah. scorn. All can desert and leave me alone. But as for me, I'll take God's part. For God is real, hallelujah, and I can feel him in my heart. Brother Richard Hopkins will lead us in prayer.
Good morning, saints. Let's bow our heads this morning. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for another day that you've allowed us to see, Father. Because, Father, through all of this COVID-19 and things going on, Father, we're leaving this world so quick, Lord.
Oh, yes.
It's not for us to stay here, Father, but, Lord, you said that, Lord, one day we're going to come before you, Father, and you're going to ask us. And Lord, I just pray that when you do ask me, Father, that I am ready, Lord, and that you would accept me, Father. But not only me, Father, but for all of us who are listening to me, Father. Because, Lord, it's not through anything that we do, we can be the best saints that there is. But, Father, you're the only one that has the last word. It's through your grace, Father, through your mercy. Father, I pray now that you would bless us on this day. I pray that something would be said, Father, to someone that might want to be saved who have never heard about you, Lord. Father, thank you, Lord, for all these things, and thank you for our nation. Father, I pray that you will bless our new president. As I pray that you will bless the former president. And Father, I pray that he can make decisions and that things that will help the nation, Father.
Yes, yes.
Because, Father, right now we're in a time of need and we're in a time of hell.
Pray.
Lord, you've made us all.
Thank you.
this day.
Thank you.
Continue to be with us, guide us, and bless us in your holy name, Jesus. For Christ's sake.
I am the Lord your God who brought you out of bondage. You should have no other gods before me. You should not make for yourself any idol. You should not invoke with malice the name of the Lord your God. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Honor your father and your mother. You should not commit murder. You should not commit adultery. You should not steal. You should not bear false witness. You should not covet anything that belongs to your neighbor. The Gloria Patri. Tennessee. We count it a joy to be in the house of the Lord one more time. You know, even though it's just two or three of us for now, we're looking for that day when we can open the doors once again to the public. And as we said in the message on last Sunday, can just have a revival and celebrate Jesus. We're looking forward to that day when we can come together again and praise God with each other. But we are reminded that the church is not the building, that we, the people, make up the church. And as long as we are together and on one accord, God will take care of us. And we're so grateful here at St. Paul that God is taking care of us. God is blessing us even in the midst of trials and tribulations. And I'm praying for increase. Even now, I'm praying for increase. And I believe that God is going to give us the increase. And we're praying that God will equip us with what we need to handle the overflow. Amen, somebody. I believe he's going to do it, y'all. I feel it in the atmosphere. And we can be thankful today that God is still blessing us, even in the midst of this virus as it continues to surge. But even with a vaccine, people are getting sick. You know, we're finding out now that we were sort of bamboozled and we're told that all of this vaccine existed. And now we're finding out that the quantities are not there as we were led to believe. But aren't you grateful that our faith is in Jesus, who is still the Christ? Aren't you grateful that while doctors and nurses can treat, God can heal? And I believe just as God has stared down pandemics in the past, he's going to do it again. Amen. We remember all of those who are on our sick and healing and deliverance list. Many who have dealt with this virus. We've even lost several in this community and within this church from the virus. But God is able. God is able. And he's just sending blessing on blessing on blessing. I know it's hard to see it right now, but God is blessing us. Amen. Even in the midst of storms. That's something to shout about, y'all. And we lift up our church family in its entirety. I thank each of you for your hard work, your dedication, and you continue to take care of your obligations to the church. I know it's a struggle, I know it's a sacrifice, but God is going to bless you in the end. Amen. We welcome now our praise team who will come to us in our sermonic selection, and Sister Andrea. Our prayers are with you and your family. Sister Andrea just lost her dad, but she's here serving. Amen.
Amen.
She said, I just got to keep working.
Amen.
So we're just praying that God will continue to strengthen you and your family as he continues to bless each of us. Let us pray for our praise team. Let us pray for each other. Amen. Thank you. my all, and all. You know, I don't know how many times you can shout, God is. Amen. But God is my all and all. And the text states in Psalm 46 and 1, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in the time of trouble. And we're just going to use for a subject, God is an ever-present help. Amen. Let us pray. Once again, Father God, we bow in humble submission. Lord, thank you for being God and God all by yourself. Thank you, Lord, for loving us in spite of our shortcomings. Thank you, Lord, for looking beyond our faults and still providing for us our need. Thank you, Lord, for being a forgiving God. Thank you for blessing us in spite of our circumstances, in spite of what's going on in the world around us. Thank you for being God and God by yourself. Satan, we know you're always somewhere, going to and fro. But Satan, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus. There's no room for you here, Satan. And we rebuke you. And we just thank you, Lord Jesus, for all you've done, all you are doing, and all you will do. And now, Father God, in another preaching hour, once again, Lord Jesus, I need your preaching power. Just move me out the way and speak what you will have me to say and what you will have the people to hear. I pray now in Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Somebody. He will not fail
to rescue those who love him and trust him. Amen. Maybe I need to say that again. He will never, the word says God never fails. He will never fail to rescue those who love him and trust him. God is an ever-present help in the time of trouble. Anybody know that? Amen. Anybody know that God is a present help, ever-present help in the time of trouble? Today's text encourages us to hope and trust in the Lord and in his power to do just what he said he would do. And make no mistake about it, God will do what God said he will do, even in the worst of times. Amen, somebody. God, once again, never fails. Now, although 45 has left the White House and no longer occupies the Oval Office, and people are breathing a sense of relief, but the truth of the matter is, as a result of the past 4 years, life continues to be full of trouble. There's turbulence all around. That's why we are reminded on today that God is still our refuge and strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. On Wednesday, January the 6th, 2021, we watched in horror as an angry mob invaded the U.S. Capitol in an act of insurrection. A week later, on Wednesday, January the 13th, the man guilty of inciting the riot was impeached for the second time in a year. And on Wednesday, the very next Wednesday, January the 20th, to the disdain of 75 million folks, Joseph R. Biden and Kamala D.B. Harris were sworn in as president and vice president of these United States of America. Although over 81 million people celebrated this event, the threats of violence were evident, and therefore we must not forget that God is an ever-present help. With confusion, stress, economic uncertainty, divisiveness, systemic racism, unequal justice, fighting within and fighting without. In the time of trouble, we are reminded that God is with us always, because the word says he's an ever-present help. Now that doesn't mean because he's an ever-present help that there won't be troubles, because the word says he's an ever-present help in the time of trouble. But it means that God will take care of us with social issues, religious differences, physical and emotional pain. God is an ever-present help. As the number of COVID-19 deaths continues to climb, and more than 24 million people worldwide have been affected by this deadly virus, God continues to be an ever-present help, because these and other things that keep filling our lives with trouble, there are those who believe that life just ain't fair. But you know, folk, even in the time of trouble, that God is still the awesome God. No matter our circumstances, God is great and greatly to be praised. He's still our refuge and our strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. And I can't emphasize enough that the Lord is help in the time of trouble. I wonder how many listening ever had to call on the Lord in the midst of your troubles. Anybody can be a witness this morning and can shout hallelujah real loud so that they can hear you on the airways, that God is an ever-present help in the time of trouble. I wonder how many listening on this Lord's Day morning know for yourself that the Lord is still good. No matter the trouble, he's still How many know without a doubt that with Jesus you can make it? That the Lord is your way maker, your way out. That he's a way anyhow. I offer on this fourth Sunday of January 2021. Can you believe that the month of January already is almost over? But that on this fourth Sunday, that even in the worst of time, God is our refuge and strength, to whom we can run to. Amen. He's an ever-present help, of whom we are safe and secure. Is there anybody out there today who's oppressed by troubles? Is there work to do but enemies to deal with? And I don't care how good you are and how much you think everybody loves you, we all got some haters out there. Amen. If so, God is our refuge, and he has the strength to bear us up when burdens threaten to knock us down. Are there any this morning in distress? If so, the Lord is our help and our present help. He's the one and only God, the living God, who's able to provide our every need. Come on, somebody. In fact, the Lord is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we ask and think, according to the power that is Holy Ghost power that working in us. The Lord is help that's always near. Jesus says, Lord, I am with you always, even until the end of time. I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. Understand, people, the Lord is not just help, he's sufficient help. He's our refuge and our strength. We cannot desire a better help, or shall we find anybody that can do us like Jesus? I believe I heard you say, Brother Frank, can nobody do me like the Lord? I wish I had some folk who could shout with authority this morning, there's nobody like Jesus. And then give God a praise, a hallelujah, because the Lord alone is an ever-present help in the time of trouble. Because God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in trouble. We don't have to fear, for the Lord our God will protect us from danger seen and unseen. With a new presidential administration, there are those who are afraid due to threats. And I thank God that they didn't materialize on this past Wednesday. Folk are frightened of what's ahead as we watch the inauguration this past week. Due to the fear of another uprising, the nation's capital was virtually under lockdown, with more than 24,000 National Guard and police officers. And due to the possibility of danger, the mayor of Washington, D.C. asked the people to stay home, the millions who would normally flock to D.C. to watch the change of guards out of fear of violence. And the deadly virus were advised to stay where you are. And I believe I heard you pray this morning, Brother Richard, just give the folk the discernment to do what they're supposed to do during this period. Oh, the traditional balls and lunches and parades were all missing. However, instead of fear of what's to come on today, the Lord sends us a word of praise that God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. And that includes fear, because the Lord says, I didn't give you a spirit
of fear, but one of love and sound understanding. When God delivered David from the hands of his enemy, David sang praises unto the Lord, and he sang, "The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My rock, my God is my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield, and the horn of my salvation." And the psalmist in today's text saying, God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. Somebody most recently said about the Lord, he's my rock, my sword, my strength, my shield. He's a wheel in the middle of a wheel. He's the lily of the valley. He's the bright and morning star. Oh, make no difference how you say it. Somebody say, I'm gonna wait right here until Jesus comes, because Jesus is mine, mine, all mine. God is an ever-present help.
Yeah.
And folk, when troubles you, you can call on Jesus. I said, when troubles you, you can call on Jesus. You don't have to call on the drug lord. You don't have to call the biggest and baddest dude in town. I said, when troubles you, you can call on Jesus, for he is our refuge and our strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. When weary, worn, and torn, and tired, you can find rest in Jesus. Therefore, that old habit that won't leave you alone, turn it over to Jesus. He's an ever-present help. Those bills that are due, and since the time of money is already gone, turn them over to Jesus. He's an ever-present help. Somebody you love but won't love you back and won't act right, turn them over to Jesus. He's an ever-present help. And as soon just as you handle one problem, something else arrive in your mailbox or left on your doorsteps. Turn it over to Jesus. He's an ever-present help. Kevin, when our souls can't find rest, turn it over to Jesus. He's an ever-present help. See, I heard the voice of Jesus say, come unto me and rest. Lay down thy weary one. Lay down thy head upon my breast. And on my way to heaven, I stop by on this Lord's Day morning just to say, when in trouble, Jesus is the peace that passes all understanding. He's help in the time of trouble. Somebody says, all my help comes from the Lord, and he's never failed me yet. All my help comes from the Lord. And somebody else asks the question, where do I go when there's no one to turn to? Who do I talk to when there's nobody to listen? Who do I lean on when there's no foundation stable? I go to the rock, and he's able. Where do I go when the storms of life are threatening? Who do I turn to? find me with the earth around me is sinking sand. Oh Christ, oh Christ, oh Christ, oh Christ, oh Christ, the solid rock I stand. When I need a shelter, I go to the rock. He's a refuge in the time of trouble. I go to the rock. I know he's able. For God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in trouble. People, no matter your trouble, remember your position and just hold on. Remember who you are and whose you are and hold on. Remember that God protects and hold on. Remember the Lord is a mighty fortress and hold on. Remember, he's a strong tower, a mighty battle axe, a hellhound chaser. And hold on, for the Lord alone is a rock of salvation. He's our refuge and our strength and ever-present help in trouble. I say God is our help and ever-present help in the time of trouble. If I can get personal for a minute, y'all, because God is my strength and my refuge and ever-present help, I refuse to be moved or shaken by the stress and mess of this old world. Just like Jesus that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved. I'm gonna lean and depend on Jesus. I won't say that there won't be times when the world attempts to catch me off guard. I won't say there won't be times when my faith is shaken or I have a reaction. But I can say that no matter what coming, I'll let nothing, absolutely nothing, separate me from the love of Jesus. When I think about the goodness of Jesus and how he's brought me through the storms and through the rain, I can shout like a song, God is my refuge and strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. And finally, folk, as we go along life's way, there will be times when we are pressed on every side, but not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair. We will be persecuted, but thank God he won't abandon. At times, struck down, but God won't allow us to be destroyed. Yes, there will be times when the hell hands will nip at our heels. We will continue to face some haters. There will be days when we'll be set by illness. At times, Sister Andrea, motherless and fatherless, we may sometimes be down, Brother Wayne, to our very last dime, almost level to the ground. But don't you dare lose heart. Stay strong. Hold on. Keep the faith. Trust in the Lord. Remember, God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. And believe, y'all, that the one true and living God, the one who raised Jesus up from the grave on that third day morning will one day raise you and raise me up because of the work that Jesus did on Calvary's cross, willingly laying down his life. Jesus has already purchased for us an eternal home, a home far beyond the skies, a home of an unclouded day, a home where Jesus himself will be waiting with arms wide open, a home where there are no color barriers, a home where there will be equal justice, a home where there be no more loneliness in the midnight hour, no more sickness, no more coronaviruses, no more protests, no more riots, no more insurrection, no more pain, no more struggling, no more suffering, no more tears, no more dying, no more setback. For one day all of this will pass and we will see our Jesus face to face. I'm talking about a home far beyond the skies, where the wicked shall cease from troubling and the weary will be at rest. And as I take my seat, if I may borrow some words from the past, I leave you with this. If you want to get to this home, then whosoever will must make a U-turn on the road of repentance, then make a right onto Believeth Boulevard, keep straight and go through the green light, which is Jesus. From there you will find the bridge of faith, which is over troubled waters. And when you get off the bridge, make a right turn and then keep straight, and you know you're on the King's highway, and heaven bound. Keep going 3 miles, one for the Father, one for the Son, and one for the Holy Ghost. Then you exit on Grace Boulevard. From there, make a right on Gospel Lane. Keep straight, then make another right on Prayer Boulevard. And on your way, yield not to the traffic on Temptation Avenue. Also, avoid Sin Street, because it's a dead end. Pass up Envy Drive, Hate Avenue, Hypocrisy Street, Gossiping Lane, and Backbiting Boulevard. But you must go down Long-Suffering Lane, Persecution Boulevard, Trials and Tribulation Avenue. From there, make a right onto Peace Street. Keep straight, and one day you'll come to the parking lot of immortality, where you will take off, pull on, turn into the parking lot and park there, get out of the body and jump in again, pull off and put on and go into the building not made by hands, where you can sit down face to face and have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about your troubles and then look back over your life and just shout your troubles over. Thank him for the mountains. Thank him for the valleys he brought you over. Thank him for the storms he brought you through. Thank him for saving you and sustaining you from sin. Thank him for the problems he's protected you from. Thank him. But if you never had a problem, you wouldn't know that God could solve them. Oh, thank him through it all, through it all, through it all, through it all. I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God through it all, through it all. I've learned to depend. feet strike Zion. May Jesus' power dip in you. May his faithfulness abide within you. May his holiness wash over you. May his justice justify you. And his kindness keep you. May the Lord's mercy mold you. And his truth still marches on. Amen. Amen. And amen. That's all the Lord told me. He wanted me to remind somebody that I am an ever-present help in the time of trouble. Woo! As we stand, God is refuge and strength and ever present help in the time of trouble. There may be somebody out there that needs to have a little talk with Jesus. There may be somebody out there that needs to give your life to Christ. There may be somebody who's been trying to make it all by yourself. But I offer that God is an ever present help in the time of trouble. If you trust him, God will take care of you. All you gotta do is just give your life to Christ. If you need to call us, we can be reached at 931-388-4069. Until we meet again, may God's grace, God's mercy, and God's peace be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.